As most of us already know that have been around a narcissist, narcissists lie to you. So what they say and what they actually mean. Some examples of the top gaslighting sentences that they say to manipulate people. To cause cognitive dissonance within our own minds. When they continually tell you one thing, yet it rarely matches your reality, then they isolate you, so you only have them for the reality checks. With the added threats they throw in, it's a terrifying, confusing place to live, and a difficult place to escape from, but people do escape from it and move on to live much happier lives. With reactive abuse, this can end up making you feel like you're the narcissist. If you have empathy for other people, you are not. Remember the three E's. If someone lacks in genuine empathy towards you, if they act entitled, and if they exploit others, no matter who they are, what disorder they have, what they tell you, they only seek to harm you, and it's time to walk away from them. People on the narcissistic personality disorder spectrum are very egotistical, self-centered, and expect others to give them everything they want without giving anything back in return. They are difficult to spot in society, and they are the masters of manipulation. They are the masters of words and lies. The lies they tell, they often believe within themselves. They use lies and manipulation so well that even when their actions don't match their words, we end up doubting ourselves and not them. Many a narcissist could possibly pass a lie detector test as they rewrite history to escape accountability. And with little to no cognitive reflection skills, their lies over time become their truths. While those around them who think empathetically and have emotional empathy end up extremely disorientated and drained, trying to look for the good in those who continue to show them their worst, mostly due to the narcissist gaslighting words. Narcissist lies are incredibly effective. Most healthy people tend to try not to lie in the first place, and when they do, they feel guilt and will often then admit to the lie, or if they do get caught, they will apologize for it, learn from it, and not do it again. So when a narcissist lies and continues to do so, often with their lies that you wouldn't even think was a lie, things like "I love you," and the more they repeat this, the more you believe this, even when their actions don't match their words. Often, as most narcissists, be it a boss, a parent, a friend, whoever they are in your life, will idolize you at some point, or they will offer intermittent plays of idolization. So when they say "I love you" or "I love your work ethics," you believe that they do from the times they have treated you so well, but it doesn't match the times they treat you so wrong. Then when they turn so cruel and cold towards you and you start to wake up from their lies and your instincts are screaming at you, they come back at you with the "play nice." And the more your mind believes those continued lies rather than the actions and the actual truth. I'm Elizabeth Shaw. Welcome to the channel, which is all about the narcissistic personality disorder, to give you more understanding of those you might be dealing with in your life, how to handle them, and ways to recover and move forward to a much happier life for you. If you do like the information on the channel, please do subscribe. Thank you very much to all the returning subscribers. And hit the bell, as I do release videos weekly, if you want notifications. The phrases they tell people and what they mean, and these can be from any narcissist within your life, not just a partner. They say, "I'd never hurt you." They mean they're not going to hurt you while you do as they please, while you take care of them, while you shower them with attention. When they say they'll never hurt you, they mean while you meet all their needs. As soon as you don't, most will go all out to destroy you until you do as they say again. They also mean they don't want you to wake up and realize what they are doing to you. Remember, only you define you. And as hard as it can be to see when someone is hurting you so much, you are in control of your emotions and your life. So finding the methods that work for you, those who continue to hurt you are not for you. They say your work is the best. They mean if it's a boss, while you're doing all the work for them, you're good, while they can play you off against other workers, all is well. They love how you come in early to work just to please them, how you go home late and miss out on things like children's bedtimes just to please them. They love how they only have to say how good your work is and you go all out to do more for them. When they say your work is the best, they meanwhile can play you off against other colleagues. While you run extra errands for them and go above and beyond your job without extra pay, they love how they are in charge of your life. If it's your parent, they love how you are running around trying to please them and doing everything they want to get their approval. If it's your partner, they love how you take care of the home, the bills, the children, so that they can do very little. Remember your boundaries. If something doesn't feel right for you, if by saying yes to someone else you are saying no to yourself, it needs to be a no. They say you're lazy. They mean that you're not doing enough for them. And even if you are doing all you can, they enjoy flipping the script to make you feel guilty and work harder to please them. They mean that you should be doing more to please them. Yet no matter how much you do, it will never be enough for them. Remember, you define you. You know if you listen to yourself enough and not those around you, when you've done enough, when you need to rest, listen to your own body and mind and do what's in the best interest for you. With good intentions, there is no right way or wrong way to live your life. You have to be at your best to give your best. They say, I love you. They mean they are just using the word love to control you and they don't really love you. They love that you make your life about them. They love how you solve their issues, relieve their pain, fix their problems. They love how you take time for them and not for yourself. They love you giving them your attention, how you make their happiness your responsibility. They love how you need them to love you. They love how they can make you feel unworthy and insignificant to try harder to please them. When they say I love you, they mean I love how you live by and respect their rules, and they love what you do to please them or what you provide for them. They do not love you for you, for who you are as a person. It's all about what you do for them. Remember, those who love you would not continue to hurt you and let you down. When you love someone, you don't want to cause or see them in pain. Only allow those to treat you in the same way you would treat others. Love yourself for who you are. Own your insecurities. We all have them, and they are nothing to be ashamed of. When we acknowledge ourselves for who we are, others cannot use our insecurities against us. They say it's not all about you. They mean, when they say this, they mean it's all about them. They cannot handle you being the center of attention. If you ever mention your needs that they don't care for, they'll make you feel guilty and ashamed for having those needs. They mean that they're the only important one and you've got to learn that their needs come first. And who you are as a person does not matter. They mean it's all about me. Remember, in actual fact, it is about you. It's about others too. It's about everyone. If you're not happy about something, you have every right to change it. If it's your life, you don't need to hurt people by walking away from those who hurt you. You've most likely tried all you can to help them and have been left a shell of your former self. Now is the time to take care of yourself before you take care of others. This is not to hurt others. This is to be at your best for those who deserve you. Good people do exist. Those who continue to treat you with disrespect don't deserve your time and attention. So respect them for who they are and walk the other way from them. They say you have trust issues. They mean they would never genuinely admit it to you, but they are very untrustworthy. And even though they have possibly shown you many times by betraying you in various forms, lying, cheating, saying they'll do one thing and doing another, they love the power and control they have over you with their words, making you doubt yourself and questioning your own sanity. You no longer know what is right or wrong unless they tell you, when you need to trust your instincts and know a narcissist will deny anything, even with facts and evidence against them. Remember, your instincts are telling you the truth. You will have trust issues around those who have lying issues. They say that never happened. They mean they don't want you to know the truth and they don't want you thinking wrongly of them. They don't want you to see what's truly happening. They want you to live by their rules. Remember your truths, no matter what they say. If you know it happened, then it happened. If you're still around them, keep a written diary until your mind sees clearly that their actions don't match their words. They say you are so jealous or insecure. They mean they enjoy seeing you compete for their attention when they flirt with others, when they triangulate you. That makes them feel powerful, in control, and wanted. They make you feel unworthy, and you often then want the narcissist more due to the trauma bond. You know what you suspect is real, but they'll do their best to manipulate you into thinking it's not real. You can never do anything right for them, and they've got you doubting yourself. So you become trauma bonded to them and don't leave because you're too afraid to leave, too afraid that you'll never find someone, too afraid of what they might do. Remember, you don't deserve someone who lets you down, who's never truly there for you, who continues to hurt you. You deserve someone you can trust, who is honest, who is open, who is caring, and who is kind like you. Anything they do, please phone the authorities. I know that's easier said than done, but it will make your life easier. And always, it is on a spectrum, so always get out safely. They say we are just friends. They mean whenever they get bored with you, they will be straight on the phone calling this person up. In case you do manage to leave the narcissist, they can simply replace you with this person and make you feel worse. This person might already be acting as a side piece to the narcissist. They'll also make sure this new person knows how controlling and toxic you are when they're ready to start the smear campaign. So if you ever talk to this person about the narcissist's behaviour, it will just confirm to the person how crazy you are. You're not actually the crazy one, but they love smearing your name and making it look that way. They love the power they have over you to humiliate you and to provoke you. When you react, it feels so good to them to have the attention, and they can show people that you act crazy, yet they never show people or tell people what led you to act that way in the first place. Remember, yes, two people can just be friends, but if it's making you feel uncomfortable, you're not insecure or sensitive, and all the other toxic gaslighting phrases the narcissist uses, you're human with feelings, and if something doesn't add up, your instincts are usually correct. They say you don't have anyone other than me, or no one will ever love you. They mean by this, is they've simply removed anyone important to you from your life. They are now the only one who has the power over your life. Of course, people would love you, but they don't want you to wake up and realize that. They want control over you, and they want you doing as they please to earn their love. Remember, you are worthy and you are lovable, and that love and happiness starts from within. You need to detach yourself from negative, toxic people who bring you down so you can discover what you enjoy in life, what you love about you. The right people will be there for you and love you for who you are. They say you're overthinking or overreacting. They mean you have perfectly normal thoughts to their behavior and normal reactions to their countless lies, but they don't want you to wake up and smell the coffee. They can never let you catch on, and they do not want you to find out. They want to make you doubt yourself in every way, and they'll make you feel like the bad person, and they'll make you feel guilty for questioning anything they do. So you work harder to please them. You will trust their words and not your own thoughts and your own feelings. They reap all the benefits while you work so hard to make it up to them and please them, forever doubting them, whilst slowly losing who you are. Remember, you were given a mind to think for yourself and how you want to think, feel and believe. And if something bothers you, internally process it and take action to change it so it no longer bothers you. Even if that means walking away from those who continue to let you down and walk away from you when you needed them the most. They say you're oversensitive. They mean they love making you feel worse, which makes them feel better. They love the power and control they have over you, and they enjoy taking advantage of your kindness and hearing you explain your good intentions to them while they take you off topic, twist your words and watch you lose yourself. They get a weird kick out of how they make you feel horrible when they mention they did something to hurt you. Yet they will have turned it all around to be your fault. They often show a smirk on their face as they watch the pain, sadness, and disappointment on your face. Remember, you are you and no one defines you, sensitive or not. That's who you are, and being sensitive means you have feelings for yourself and for others. Good people will respect those feelings. They say, "I'm sorry you feel that way." They mean they're not sorry you feel that way. They don't have the emotional empathy to care for how you feel. They are just saying this so they can continue their abusive behavior. They are only ever sorry that they got caught. They feel no need to apologize, but they will say, "I'm sorry, you," meaning they are not sorry for what they did. They are feeling sorry for themselves, that they are being made to apologize for the things they believe that they are entitled to do. They will always turn it on to you. They care. They do not care for your emotions or how you feel. They only care about what they can get from you. Remember, if someone continues to hurt you and they don't change their hurtful behavior towards you, they don't care for you. This is just further manipulation. They say you'll never find someone like me. They mean they know it would be the best thing to ever happen to you if you never found someone like them. There are so many people in the world that would treat you far better than the narcissist ever did, but they want to make sure that that never happens for you. They want you so hooked on them that you'll only be free when they have done with you, by which point you'll be so broken and trauma bonded, you'll not trust anybody. And if you do start to recover, prepare for the narcissist Hoover. They will swoop back in as a changed person, and you need to make sure you know within yourself that they will never change. They are who they are. They have a disorder. Those on the disorder have a disorder. It's who they are. And they haven't learnt the strategies or coping mechanisms to deal with the disorder that they have. The only things they've learned is to blame everybody else for the problems within their lives and to bring other people down. Remember that good people do exist, and the sooner you remove those from your life that put your light out, that put you down, that squash you and take away all your hopes, your dreams, your happiness, your money, your health, and all the other things that they steal from you. As soon as you remove negativity, you make way for positivity, your inner love, your dreams, your happiness, your joy, and your kind of people. Hopefully this video will explain to you why, after coming out of a narcissistic relationship, you end up doubting everything around you, whether that was your parents, a boss, a work colleague, a friend or partner, or even your own child, and doubting everyone around you. Most people do come out and they do feel judged and daft and silly, or they say things like, this is going to sound stupid. They're often too scared to tell people in case they sound crazy. And if you're feeling like that, you are not stupid, you are not silly. People aren't judging you, people have lived it. And those that judge you are not for you. You are not crazy. Now is the time to rebuild yourself and cut negativity out of your life. And if you have children, out of your children's lives. You are not silly, crazy or stupid just because one person manipulated you. Or even if a few manipulated you. You just love and you care and you're kind and you want to see the good in others. You can always change things for yourself. You can always move on. You may have anxiety and you can heal anxiety. You may have CPTSD. You can and you will overcome CPTSD. It's all about working on you now. It's normal to feel these things and it's normal to have these effects after this kind of relationship, and you are far from alone in how you feel. People out there do understand and have been through similar. Trust yourself again. Learn to listen to those instincts and believe in who you are. And if you don't know who you are right now, that's okay. Just ask, who am I? And just keep asking yourself, go out and try new things, do things that you enjoy, work on the anxiety, going out and try new things. They coincide with each other. So as you're taking those steps, it helps with your anxiety. As you help work on your anxiety, it helps taking those steps to move forward. You're allowed your own thinking. You're allowed your own mindset. And when you're in that kind of relationship, your subconscious has been retrained to think how they want you to think. And now is the time that you need to work on you to retrain your subconscious with your conscious to think how you want to think, to have the mindset you want, to change those negative thoughts into positive thoughts, to trust. Know that everyone's allowed an opinion, and if you don't agree, you are allowed to disagree and move on from them with no harm done. You can work on yourself. Some people recover with self-taught research, others with support groups, therapists, EMDR treatment. It's finding the right coping strategies for you and then using them to work for you. The best relationship you can have is one with yourself. So work on yourself today. Tell yourself you can do this and you will. Love you for who you are. Life isn't always easy. When we go against our instincts and go easy on the people that make us unhappy, life becomes incredibly hard. When we start listening to our instincts, tuning into our instincts, when we work on ourselves, life becomes so much easier and so much full of joy and happiness. It is nobody's fault getting into these kind of relationships. We do have to accept responsibility for our own actions. At the same time, when you haven't learnt about something, you don't know what you're getting into. And it's the same as abuse.
Nobody deserves to be abused. You deserve to live a happy, healthy life. So start creating those dreams for the future of where you would like to be a year from now. And when you're having those bad moments, those bad days, focus on those thoughts, focus on the good, focus on the present moment. Find something, three things in your day to be grateful for. Something that you're proud of, something that you've achieved. I will add in the description a video on cognitive dissonance. I'll add a video on gaslighting, coercive control, and the mind games that narcissistic people play to give you more information. I'll also add the links to the courses that I have. Thank you very much for listening. And if anyone has any advice, this is about a community of people helping each other. Excuse me, helping each other and supporting each other through this. Thank you. So if you do have any advice or help for others, please do add it in the comments. Thank you very much for listening. Bye.